次咧都唔係好知 DSE 海外嘅應受性係點樣啦，咁可能會擔心嘅。但係當睇翻考評局嗰啲資料啊，咁樣都發現其實海外對佢嘅應受性都係良好嘅，咁所以都會對佢比較有信心。
新學制嘅好處咧，就係學生可以自由選擇啲科目嚟讀咯，變咗根據自己興趣同埋嗰個能力嚟選科咯。
而家個升學計劃就諗住係可能升讀一下一啲其他嗰啲課程啦，咁或者可能會出嚟工作咯，可以俾自己磨練一下。
出路咧就一定多好多嘅選擇，好闊，要 cater 到唔同程度嘅學生咯。
The new senior secondary NSS curriculum has been implemented since 2009. Under the new academic structure, every student has the opportunity to take part in a 3-year junior secondary and a 3-year senior secondary course. To tie in with the curriculum and to measure the attainment of students, the Hong Kong Examinations and Assessment Authority, HKEAA, introduced the brand new Hong Kong Diploma of Secondary Education, HKDSE examination, to replace the Hong Kong Advanced Level and Hong Kong Certificate of Education examinations. In 2012, over 70,000 candidates took the first HKDSE examination.
This is a question. On the basis of the results, I think... We will continue to work
hard to promote the results of the Chinese language test and the results. We have more than 130 foreign universities. They have accepted the results of the Chinese language test.
The Hong Kong EAA has been working very hard in promoting the Hong Kong DSE. I'm very happy to report that many institutions from Hong Kong, from around the world, have accepted our qualification for entry. I think this is a very positive sign, very encouraging. I'm also happy to report that as far as employers are concerned, for example, the Hong Kong Civil Service Bureau have also accepted our qualification for entry. Not only saying that this is a confidence in the Hong Kong EAA, but in fact, it represents their trust in the entire education system in Hong Kong.
I think that all UK institutions this year are accepting the DSE. I think it's been very well accepted.
Under the NSS curriculum, more varieties of subjects are offered to students. Apart from the 4 core subjects, students can also take 2 to 3 elective subjects based on their preferences. Unlike previous public examinations, standards referenced reporting is adopted for all 24 category ANSS subjects. Putting it simply, candidates whose performance reached a certain standard will be awarded the corresponding level, regardless of the results of other candidates. A detailed set of written descriptors for level 1 to level 5 is in place to specify students' ability and performance.
Teachers and students can refer to the descriptors and learn how they can get better results so that they can improve their teaching and learning.
In addition to written examinations, school-based assessment is also introduced to the HKDSE examination to allow a more comprehensive appraisal of candidates' competence.
School-based assessment are actually conducted by teachers within their own schools. The HKEAA plays the very important role of monitoring the work and also the standards. We collect samples of work, we moderate the results of the assessment based on other sources of information to ensure that students get a fair mark.
The assessment of applied learning subjects is conducted by individual course providers. The HKEAA is responsible for the moderation of the assessment results. The marking and grading of other language subjects are undertaken by Cambridge International Examinations. To help candidates to better understand the examination procedures, the HKEAA has set up a Public Examinations Information Centre to answer inquiries on public examinations.
你好啊，咁请问你系学校考生，定系自修生呢？
The Information Centre provides support and assistance to candidates throughout the whole public examination cycle so that they can complete their examinations smoothly. To achieve the objectives of the new curriculum, the design of examination questions in the HKDSE examination is more diversified. More open-ended questions are included to assess students' thinking skills and application of knowledge.
The question papers are actually set by what we call moderation committees, which consists of members from the tertiary institutions, from frontline secondary school teachers, in addition to our own subject managers. They spend months to about a year to complete a paper.
After the examination, all answer scripts are scanned within 72 hours, and the images are saved and retained in a secure database. The images of the answer scripts are then distributed to markers for marking via a secure intranet system. More than 90% of the HKDSE scripts are marked on screen. The system facilitates the monitoring of markers' progress and marking quality.
Double marking is adopted in many of the HKDSE papers, particularly open-ended questions. The OSM system will automatically distribute the papers to two different markers so that students will get two independent assessments. If the marks awarded by the first marker differs quite a lot from the second markers, then the script will be sent to a third marker or even a fourth marker for marking so that students will get the fairest mark that they deserve.
After the completion of marking, each subject will be graded by an expert judge panel according to standards reference procedures. The results will then be reviewed and approved by the Public Examinations Board.
I think what we've got is a five-star and five double star because they're sort of sub-groupings of a level.
The Public Examinations Board is made up of representatives from the Education Bureau, the HKEAA, tertiary institutions and secondary schools. All HKDSE examination results need to be endorsed by the board to ensure all candidates receive the fairest and the most reliable results.
The first Hong Kong DSE has been completed smoothly. What is most special for me is this feeling of working together. I feel that our staff are very professional. They don't treat this as just a job because they know how important it is for the candidates. So they work very, very hard and put in all their heart and efforts. And it's beyond Hong Kong EAA. I find that our stakeholders, the schools in particular, and the parents, the candidates themselves, and also other stakeholders like the Hong Kong Education Bureau. We all work together seamlessly for the good of the candidates and for Hong Kong. I'm confident that students with the Hong Kong DSE qualification will lead to better opportunities ahead and equip them for the 21st century's challenges.